Thanks for the support, and thanks for the press. Makes a difference, and appreciate all of you. It's a fun time of year with school starting, football starting, and all the other sports starting. And it's fun to start the school with our sport. Love to introduce our staff. I'm going to introduce a bunch of guys, and one of them has been in the same role last year. So many guys have different roles. We moved some guys around on the staff, elevated some guys, but I'm excited about this recipe. And as a head coach, every decision you make, you need to make a decision that betters your program, and these decisions have done that. Offensive coordinator Jason Eck, also the offensive line coach. Luke Schleissner is going to be our passing game coordinator and tight ends coach. Jimmy Rogers is going to be our co-defensive coordinator and also linebackers. Brian Bergstrom's co-defensive coordinator and safeties. Dan Jackson is associate head football coach, recruiting coordinator, and cornerbacks. Christian Smith takes on a new job as the D-line coach instead of just the D-tackles coach. Robert Arnheim is our wide receivers coach. And then two guys in totally new positions, Jimmy Beal is our running backs coach, and Spencer Erickson is our assistant D-line coach. The director of football operations is John Schaefer. He's new. FCS football changed the rules this year, and you can have two GAs now that coach. So we've made that change. Thanks for the support. Because of the support of our administration, so we have two veterans in our program. Tyler Weir is going to be our offensive GA, and Jesse Bobbitt is going to be our defensive GA. And then probably the most important guy in our program, I shouldn't say probably, is our strength coach, Nate Moe, who is around our guys much more than we are and impacts them in a big way. Based on the polls, there's very high expectations for our program. I would say in our locker room, there's higher expectations. And that's fun to be a part of a program like that. We have great leadership. We have six guys that were voted captains in the middle of spring ball. And this year they led through spring ball, they led through the summer, and they're doing a great job of leading this fall. And to be honest with you, it's humbling how hard our guys work to pursue their goals. We have some very good football players in our program, as witnessed by some preseason honors. Special teams, Chase Vinatieri and Brady Sorensen are back at kicker and snapper. Those guys are veterans. I don't think there's been some really good specialists here, but those two guys are special. And Brady is voted a preseason All-American. And then our punting duty will be handled right now by Ben Dinkle, who's a new guy in our program. Hate to have his job because he's following a guy that was phenomenal in Brady Hale, but Ben's got a neat attitude, and he's going to embrace it, and he's going to do a great job. Offensively, we're led by a ton of really good skill players. Our running backs are, I guess they use the term, loaded. Mikey Daniels is a senior. Pierre Strong is the freshman of the year in the conference. C.J. Wilson is a very skilled guy, and then you'll see Luke Sellers, our fullback, carry the ball some. So, and there's a number of other guys, and so it's really exciting. What Coach Beal's done with those guys. Wide receivers are led by Kay Johnson, preseason All-American, and Adam Anderson. And Adam's kind of lost with the Jake Winnekes and the Kay Johnsons, but Adam is a phenomenal football player, along with a number of guys. And their offensive line is still kind of in the making, but it's really going to be anchored by our two tackles, Evan Greenway and Aaron Johnson, and excited that Matt Clark found his way back to our football program. Interesting story. But he appreciates it, and we love the guy, and he's making a difference in our program. Defensively, play a lot of guys at the D-line, different than we've done. D-end will be led by Ryan Arith, who's a phenomenal football player, and then D-tackle to South Dakotans, Crockett Krolikowski and Xavier Ward will anchor that. Linebacker crew is not very deep, but it's, again, I think as good as we've had here. Christian Roseboom is a three-time All-American. Logan Backus is a phenomenal player. And Levi Brown is probably the other starter who's having a better fall than a lot of guys. So excited about those guys. Defensive back, Josh Mianchigaya, and transfer Michael Griffin should start at safety. And then cornerbacks, a little beat up right now, but Don Gardner is a veteran there, and he should anchor that group along with a number of guys. We will be missing two starters at the start of the season. Wes Genant and Marshawn Harris will not be there right away, but they'll be back soon. Freshmen, we got the unique rule. We have the unique rule where you can play guys four games, and so just like we did last year, in the first year of that, we'll scatter them in at different times. We will pull some red shirts because this is a very talented class, but look for a lot of guys to play in that freshman class. As fans, we have a great schedule. I know we open on the road against Minnesota, but we have a number of home games, seven home games, and a great opportunity to support not only a football program, but the athletic department by showing up and making a difference in the stands. You've heard me talk for a number of years now of different goals and different things we want to attack. The last 2 years we've been semifinalists, and we've been close enough to smell the finals. And I'm going to follow our senior class and our players in the goal this year, and Brock's already said it, to be 1-0. And if we can do that, good things will happen. Thanks for being here.